What is going on, guys? Gino checking back in for another video today. It is the 2nd of October and it's 7:45 a.m. at the moment. This is give or take the last week of cutting, so I figured to give you guys a little physique update in the mirror right here since, well, this is some half natty lighting. The hunger is kicking in bad, man. This is probably the lowest calories I've been eating, I believe, in years or something. So it is definitely becoming time to just add in some extra calories and just get on the lean gain train again. So here's the physique in the morning. Doubting to go for another photo shoot since I do like to have kind of like an end goal in mind when it comes to cutting. Because, well, at the end of the day, when are you actually lean enough? That's something that I still kind of struggle with sometimes, so I'm still contemplating that, but in any case, I think I'm pretty much lean enough right now. So, nearly 8 a.m. right now. I gotta go train a client at 10 a.m., so without further ado, let's get some breakfast in. Look at this majestic beast of a bowl of cream of wheat right here. Nearly poured out of the bowl. Is anybody else like this, that you actually look forward to your breakfast every single day for years on years on years? Well, at least I know I am. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna be mixing this together. Eat it, obviously. I'm gonna do a little bit of work on the computer. And as mentioned, have to be in the gym at 10 a.m. to train a client. And after that, I'm going to be training back and biceps, AKA a pool workout. Sipping on some coffee as well. Cheers. Right, guys, so a meal that I've been making when I need to go to the gym and pretty much train right afterwards is some potatoes and chicken. I got 235 grams of air fried white potatoes and 163 grams of air fried chicken. Especially when it comes to my pre-workout nutrition, I like to have things planned out, right? If I have to eat some grab together meal like right before my workout, I do tend to notice a difference when it comes to performance, pump, endurance, etc. So proper planning prevents poor performance. Be sure that if you know that you have to train and you have to eat on the go, then just prepare something the day before or right before you leave the house. It is freezing outside, guys. Especially the fact that I'm cutting right now doesn't help, because I tend to notice that I get cold very easily, but as I mentioned, it won't be long anymore. Basically, when it comes to my cutting progress, the only thing that I've really been focusing on is making sure that I'm getting my 10,000 steps in per day. So that is a little bit up comparing to one or two videos ago. I believe two videos ago right now. I'm back on the upload game, guys. So I'm reaching 10,000 steps per day, eating 2,300 to 2,400 calories at the moment, which, as I mentioned, not a lot of calories for me, so I'm definitely feeling hungry and a little bit drained, especially when it comes to my workouts, but we're fighting through. Let's go to the gym. Claiming that a row is a trapezius focused exercise as it is, and that a pull down or pull up is a lat focused exercise. Truth be told, when you change the biomechanics of any specific back exercise, you can make it a trapezius focused exercise or a lat focused exercise. And it all comes down to either retracting and protracting the scapula, which will make it a lot more trapezius focused. And if you purely focus on shoulder extension, which is putting the elbow low and hitting the shoulder low, that way you're changing the entire
direction and emphasis of the specific exercise that you're going for. So keep those things in mind. If you want to grow lats, keep the shoulders down. If you want to grow the trapezius, squeeze the shoulder blades. All right, guys, so for this specific exercise, the high row or just a plate-loaded row, if you want to put the most emphasis on the lats, what you need to be focusing on is putting your elbow as low as possible and keeping your shoulder as low as possible as well. So that you're purely focusing on this specific end of the exercise. Basically what it comes down to is, if you want to put emphasis on the traps, be sure to squeeze between the shoulder blades. If you want to put emphasis on the lats, put your shoulder down and the elbow down. Kind of row towards the hip. Alright guys, that was an awesome session. Absolutely awesome session. The last two training sessions, or pretty much all training sessions of this week, were pretty mediocre in my opinion. The energy wasn't there, feeling kind of fatigued, cold, but again, those are pretty much side effects of being in a caloric deficit for a pretty long time. I think I'm like 12 or 13 weeks in or so, so definitely time, especially when I saw the footage of this training. I'm getting freaking lean enough. So without further ado, I'm going to be heading home right now, get a little protein shake in, a couple of rice cakes, and then wait until dinner, which pretty much leaves me with a empty feeling in my stomach for a couple of hours. The things we do when we're cutting, man.
Alright guys, for dinner I'm going to be making a nice little solid rice meal. What I typically like to make most for dinner, if I'm cooking myself, I'm cooking for Romy and myself today, I like to make something with rice, some mixed vegetables right here, and either a beef protein source, chicken protein source, or some shrimps, or whatever. So what I have right here are some garlic marinated shrimps, two packets, one for me, one for Romy, kind of mixed together. Some bell peppers, broccoli, red onions, green onions, and so forth as the veggie source. And of course, some whole grain rice.
Going to be cooking this up right now and show you guys the end product, Chef Gino style. If only you guys had smell-o-vision right now.
Alright guys, here's the end product. So we got some shrimps right here, around 100 to 150 grams, broccoli, red onion, green onion, you know the stuff. Whole grain rice, and of course, the lovely girlfriend has the same.
Hi.
All right guys, let me get this belt off me real quick. All right guys, so pretty cool announcement. I've partnered up with a really cool and amazing brand called Thor Athletics. They develop these really cool and amazing lifting belts and a lot of other lifting gear as well, such as wrist wraps right here, knee sleeves, and honestly, I'm not just saying this because I've partnered up with this brand, but the quality of the lifting straps in particular, since that is the thing that I use pretty much the most, are insane. They feel a lot more smooth and soft in terms of like the fabric that they use, which I haven't really experienced before, because normally when I use straps, I tend to get like these really irritated wrists, because it tends to get really, really tight and it kind of like scrapes across my wrist. But these
like honestly, I am freaking satisfied with them. So if you want to check them out and want to get some awesome lifting gear, be sure to check the link in the description to go to Thor Athletics. And if you want to save 10% off to get you some epic deadlift gains, squat gains, back gains, and just gains in general, then be sure to use my code GINO10 for 10% off your entire order. All right, guys, so regarding the cutting phase, as I mentioned, I'm pretty much done with cutting right now. What I tend to notice year after year, if I don't have an end goal for my cutting phase when I'm trying to lose body fat, I tend to not really know when to stop. And I purely need to check myself with the fact that, okay, I'm looking lean enough. I don't have a specific end goal. I'm not cutting for a specific photo shoot or for a competition in general. So I needed to be realistic with myself, and I decided that this is just the final week of cutting, and after this I'm going to be jumping straight back to maintenance. Now this is where the whole topic of reverse dieting versus jumping straight back to maintenance comes in. I used to be a big fan of reverse dieting, which simply implies that you increase your calories by 100 each and every week until you reach your new maintenance level. And by new maintenance level I mean your lowered maintenance level, since you obviously weigh less at the end of a cut, so you need to adjust your calories accordingly. And I've done reverse diets pretty much every single time besides after my competition, but this time I've decided to just simply go back to my new maintenance. The scientific literature isn't really supportive of reverse dieting, and reverse dieting is basically something that you can utilize if you prefer it. Like if you tend to notice that you are extremely hungry and you have potential to go out for cheap meals or go on a binge, then reverse dieting may be the best solution for you. Even though that I know that it's not necessary, I still use this strategy for some of my clients, since some people just tend to have a lot more potential to go on binges. And of course, especially after a long cutting phase or a cutting phase in general, you don't want to throw all of that hard work that you've been putting in for weeks or months out of the window because you go on a binge and eat every single food in sight. So for some people, it might be psychologically better to increase your calories weekly to not have all of the calories to play with all of a sudden. And for the majority of people, or for most people, it will probably be better to just jump straight back to maintenance, increase your calories, get out of a deficit, and start going on the lean gain train again. So be realistic with yourself. If you tend to notice that you're extremely hungry and you have the potential to pig out when you're done cutting, then for the love of God, just do a reverse diet. And if you don't have trouble with any of those things, then just hop straight back to maintenance, man. On another note, I ordered two new camera lenses. I've ordered the Sigma 60mm 1.4 lens and the Sigma 30mm lens. And this is something that I've been looking into for a very long time. And I just wasn't sure if the quality was going to be that much better. But after researching it very properly and looking at a lot of examples on YouTube, I just decided to take the plunge. Now, in case you guys are unaware, lenses often cost even more than the whole body of the camera, which is what you put the lens on. So it's definitely safe to say that it was quite an investment. But something that I personally stand for as well is that you need to put energy or focus into the things that you want to get the most out of at the end of the day. So you can expect to see some freaking high-ass quality coming very, very soon. All right, and that's all for this video, guys. I sincerely hope you all enjoyed. If you did, please be sure to smash the like button, because it truly helps out the channel grow. Comment down below and subscribe to the channel. And turn post notifications on for so much more content coming really soon. I'm out, guys, and peace out. See you in the next one.